week, we covered blooper reels. It's been funny, you know, but this week, we're going to be doing a video of the top 10 championship days throughout all of Jesters history. And these are just shows we had on championship days. And you know, there's one on Saturday if you want to go see it. Wink, wink, nudge, nudge, please come see it. So, without further ado, why am I even talking? Let's start the thing! Top 10 championship day shows for Jesters history!
All I do is win, 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 no matter what. Got money on my mind, I can never get enough. And every time I step up in the building, everybody hands go up. And they stay there, and they say yeah, and they stay there.
The 2014 championship was weird for me. That was our transition year. That whole year was weird. I think the league ended up performing in 4 different venues before landing in the schools. Because that year was kind of like a pilot year for the league in the schools, in the school district.
I think that championship had so much more tension to it than many championships before. Not that any of them weren't great, but it was the fact that we were in a school, our numbers were growing, so there was always a larger audience. There was seemed to be more at stake.
That championship was kind of like a whirlwind of emotions. First of all, because I want to be better than my brother, and we're super competitive against each other. And second of all, just because that whole season and finally being able to perform like inside of a high school was just like intense. It was so crazy.
I remember the beginning is we found out that we were facing them, and we kind of all just stood there for a second, and we looked at the team, and we were like, all right, guys, I don't know if we're going to win this, but we're going to give it our best effort, and we're going to try and, like, beat them, because we know that they're the best.
There's this energy on stage that every person, even though we were on 2 separate teams, was working with each other, and I distinctly remember thinking in my head that even our competing scenes were going so well that no matter who won at the end of that show, it was undeniably probably one of the best shows I've been a part of.
You had a CTA team that had the exact same feelings that the old Palo boys did. You had a Centennial team, especially with Alexis in there, that were humble to be there and itchy. They were not scared of the CTA boys whatsoever. But if you want to, in my opinion, the most lopsided championship show out of all of them. CTA won this by a mile. No.
Ludacris going in on the verse because I've never been defeated and I won't stop now.
Was like the 2011 matchup. Palo Verde's first year in the championship. Is that accurate? That's accurate.
This was a nervous Palo Verde team against an excited Green Valley team.
I was so nervous that I remember after we did like the championship and then the coaches show, after I went outside, I was wearing like Van sneakers and they were like completely dark with sweat. Like I sweat through my shoes like entirely. And I was just like so hot and nervous. I want to see what I looked like on stage, because I'm sure I was rocking back and forth and just sweating profusely.
The competition was feeling a little bit more like a competition, and you know, all of us really were on the same kind of playing field. We were all really honing our craft and really good at that stage. But again, it was still pretty small, so it felt really familiar, felt really just close-knit and just fun, no nerves or anything at all.
I did improv with Jesters. That was my first year doing that, time of my life, and that was also the year I was playing lacrosse. And I won a state championship in lacrosse that same year that we won the state championship of high school Jesters, and the Jesters was infinitely more important.
I remember a little bit more of Green Valley in that show, and the town hall meeting and their characters, and I think they came to play. And did Palo edge them out? Yeah, absolutely. But that was a neat show to be a part of. That felt like a championship.
I think my parents said they were proud, but that could just be being wishful.
All I do is win, 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 no matter what. Got money on my mind, I can never get enough. And every time I step up in the building,
so we're talking the first 4 years in the league. 2013 championship day was the bar that got set for what is championship day now.
2013, Las Vegas's most historic school, Northwest Baconado Ranch.
It was pretty intense because we were in a room that we weren't used to like performing in. We were in like the big showroom. And I remember it kind of started off a little bit like shaky, and then we started like kind of gaining momentum, I guess. And
I don't think we expected at all to win that year because we lost Brad and Brennan. But that year we were able to like, me and Corey would use our like seniority and kind of knowing the ropes that we had this comfort to it and this kind of, I mean, we're not going in expecting anything out of this, so let's just let it all out there, and it worked.
I remember everyone kept telling us that we weren't going to win, but we won another t-shirt, and I was on a picture on Anthony Cool's Instagram.
I was basically in every single scene, and I was like putting full throttle, and I tried to do my best, but Cole was always like better than me, and so was Danny, and then that third guy who liked to act like a bird.
So I just full on just ready. This was my year. This was my senior year. I was coaching this year. I had a lot of knowledge. I was giving back to the community, and I still didn't win. Yo, can you believe it? Spoiler alert.
And let's just say we were all rooting for Sam and Squad to get that Galeno for a second. Anastasia to get one. Sam was deserving, but man, those Palo boys, they really built a legacy. Nothing compared to the 2012 championship between Palo Verde and Green Valley. You have the All-Stars from the charity tournament, Brad, Danny, Brad 2 and Danny 2, against the Eltons and Axel Elton. Family versus clones. Who was gonna win? We didn't know.
The Palo Verde team had competed in a charity tournament that year. It was a Las Vegas citywide tournament, and just that team from Jesters actually competed as a team, and they beat teams of adults. They made it to the final four of that charity tournament against a bunch of adults, and I believe they were only a point or a couple of points away from the championship of that tournament. So when it came to Jesters, they kind of steamrolled everybody.
We were practicing like so much with that team because we had the ability to be practicing at school and then also on the weekends with Jesters. We were just so in sync and just vibing that year. I went in really confidently, but like we were still like fully prepared to lose, but it was just such a fun year because we were hanging out constantly, we were all practicing constantly, and we knew each other so well that going into the playoffs for that year, the energy was just there.
So at this point, I had three completely different teams over like the 3 years, and I was struggling against those Palo boys so bad. Because, I mean, they were friends and hung out outside of school, you know, they had inside jokes, they just jived really well together. And that year, man, I was getting in my head about it, you know, this is my third year.
Alexis Park, stage was bigger, lights were brighter, and our trophy was shinier. So, that's all I remember from that.
Has your life changed from being a part of Jesters? Well, think about why. Because of this year, 2010, the first year we met Greeny and Sam and Lino and Milkshake and Lauren with the pace of the potty mouth around her head. That image was used for years. It was just an epic day to show that this league could really become something for the community, for high school kids all around, and eventually for other states.
So the 2010 championship was 100% the best show of the year.
It was probably the first show I actually really stopped being so shy and had a few really good jokes, so Greeny wasn't carrying the entire team.
he carried. Doesn't matter what anybody says, he carried. I'm man enough to admit that.
I steamrolled those freshman girls as a fully adult 18-year-old male. I came in there, and I didn't show any mercy. I just kept going, put the team on my back.
I just remember it not feeling like a competition. It didn't feel like a competition because we all knew each other so well, and we were there practicing with each other, which doesn't happen anymore. So all the different schools, all the different teams, we were practicing together. So when it came down to the championships, like, I wasn't nervous at all. It just felt like another practice, another, you know, fun time with my friends. And when it was over, it was just really sad. We just couldn't wait until the next year.
In the end, it was kind of power versus skill, and power edged it out. And it doesn't always work that way.
I came to win! And I did win, you know.
It was the first year where I think Kobe realized we have something special.
This was an exciting championship show, and not only was it exciting, the result of that championship show, it still left us excited. Like, when we got those scores, and we were looking at the scores, and then we had to figure out what to do about that tie, we were all still that excited.
And definitely had, like, the most hype around it, I feel like, but then again, that also could have been because I was on the team. But it was a very good show, despite all the complications that day.
It was crazy because the flood, the whole flood, so for all the kids on both sides just to adapt and improv their way to a spectacular show like it was to come down to a tie.
To start it off, I think I was so nervous that I actually went and cried in the bathroom twice. I made a peach cobbler that day. I also cried while I made the peach cobbler. It's a lot of crying going on.
I think we came out and we did pretty good. You know, for being completely brand new, all four of us just never in a championship show. But I think we really came out and it was a fun time, and East Tech played really well.
The three boys the year before them, Aaron, Colton, and Ricky, kind of left this legacy. And so they kind of took themselves out of that shadow and made it all the way to the championship. And I think, again, nobody was expecting ECTA because Duke was such a phenomenal player that everybody kind of looked at Northwest as a little bit of the favorite, but ECTA went in there and played their best show, and it couldn't have been any better. I mean, I remember to do Rap Rap, I think we played it twice. Like, it got to a point where Colton and Duke had, I mean, they must have went 12 rounds, and then somebody messed up, and everybody was confused, and then Kobe's just like, let's do it again! And then those guys went another, like, 10 rounds. It was insane. And then ECTA ended up, you know, edging Duke out, but it was great, great show.
I think it was a complete shock to everybody. I don't think anybody was looking at Desert Oasis that year thinking, oh, this is a team that's championship ready. They just developed themselves and became that. They worked hard and they did it. It was the ragtag group of kids that just poured their heart into the improv and into the work. They asked me to come in and run extra practices because they wanted to win it. So, Cinderella story, Desert Oasis, coming out of nowhere and winning the championship.
Just so much fun. Just the way that everyone's brains worked on that team, it wasn't even like we were performing. Just every scene that we did together was like a circus act. Just it was insane, and it was just a lot of fun. And Desert Oasis was a great team. And what did the game we played? We played
Six Things,
but also Continuation. Or what's the one where you continue after the last line? First line, last line. And it was honestly one of the best games of first line, last line I've ever played. It was so much fun.
I just remember the energy of it, you know. I really loved having fun. That's all I could think about. It was probably some of the most fun I had in the longest time in high school.
In the middle of that championship show, I remember thinking, like, holy cow. Like, Desert Oasis has a fighting chance in this. And you couldn't help but laugh and and almost cry at how much you were laughing at what Desert Oasis was doing. I don't think there's anyone in the league that would have watched that league that year and thought Desert Oasis was going to win. But this is our true one Cinderella story. There are things that happened in that championship show that have not been as good since then. In 2017, you thought East Tech, Northwest, at the time Park, were going back. It was hands down a rematch. It just didn't work that way. And so now you had two teams that no one had on their radar. And I remember even talking to the coaches, and the coaches were like, I don't think people think that we should be in the championship. This was the precedent of championship teams getting together to practice to put on a good championship show.
The Shot Palace show was exciting, nerve-wracking, and just, we kind of made a fool of ourselves, both good and bad. I remember jumping off the stage in the musical scene.
The musical scene that Chaparral played is one of my favorite scenes that I've seen in a championship show.
Of course, we had to play musical scene, which is my least favorite game, but everybody tells me that it was like one of the most memorable parts of that championship day.
When we played musical scene, we still hate that to this day.
We loved that show, and again, just that Shap and Paolo can go back and forth and put on the best show possible to kind of elevate each team.
The audience was awesome. It really didn't matter who won. We just had an amazing time. Which is, I feel like, Jesters in general.
That was my favorite one, not just because we won, but like, Freddy's a monster, and so is Tirza. So they just crushed my insides with their funniness.
I think both teams should be absolutely proud of what they did. Paolo, hands down, was as crisp as they could have been to get that win. This has to be one of the best championship shows.
Tuakan vs. Paolo was, without a doubt, one of the best pure improv performances I've ever seen.
Just every minute of that show was just so much fun to take in. I thought the two teams just really connected together on stage and worked well together. There was competition, but it wasn't animosity. It was just fun. We want to put on a good show more than anything else.
We just wanted to see how electric it could be and how much we could push the envelope. And that's what I loved about Palo Verde and I loved about Tuakan is they weren't afraid to take the stage, work to each other, and kind of elevate each other on the stage. And just sitting in the back as a coach, like, it almost makes you want to watch, but you don't want to watch because both teams were swinging. And
I was pretty much just pacing in the back. I have a hard time relaxing when I can't do anything to help my team. They're just up there and they have to just do the thing. I can't coach, I can't say anything.
Both teams came out and did things that we had never seen before. They were in the sand, drawing stuff up to try and make this show as good as it could have been. And let's argue, man, let's split hairs. Both teams should have won. Like, that's how good that show was.
We didn't care, like, who won or who was going to win. We just wanted to make each other look good and to play the games the best that we could. It was so much fun.
We were laughing so hard because they were playing the piano. And I've never seen anyone do that before. And then someone almost drowned themselves because they had their face in a bucket of water.
I personally really liked the show because the Tuakan team is really pretty. So the whole time I was just staring at Macy.
This was a fantastic show. I was happy to be on stage with both of those teams.
Kopi, what do you mean? Tuakan versus Palo Verde was only number 2 on the list. What could be better than that show? That show had people dunking in water. Well, before we can get to that, I swear to God, Kopi, if you're pulling another one of those on me. Before we get to that, we're going to be doing a recap of numbers 10 through 2. So, yeah. Already brushing off the dust. You hear my voice, you hear that sound. Like thunder gonna shake the ground. You held me down, but I got up. Get ready, cause I've had enough. I see it all, I
feel something, if you want to walk out of a room feeling like you were friends with 500 to 1,000 other people, and you might not know all of those people, come to Championship Day. And if you want to talk about hype and building towards a moment, we're talking about the 10th anniversary, we're talking about 10 years of work, we're talking about doing something revolutionary. You may have liked Tuakon and Palo. You may like the story of Greeny in his first year, but I'm in love with the idea of the story that's about to be told for the 2019 championship.
Show up, I guess. There's probably snacks at the snack bar.